Thank you all for coming today. We appreciate everybody. I know there's been some folks that came a long way today to be here for this celebration of Brother Hernandez. And we just want to thank you all for coming and being a part of this service today. Brother Hernandez was loved very much, and so we appreciate everybody here. Let's just start this service off with the word of prayer and ask the Lord to be with us here today. Can you say amen? Amen. Lord Jesus, we love you today. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness, your mercy to each and every one of us here in this service today. We ask that you would be with us in a special way today, God, that you would strengthen and comfort the family that have gathered here today, that you would wrap your arms around us, Lord, and give us comfort and strength, Lord, during this time and in this service today, God. Give the family strength, God, and today and in the coming days, God, be with them, Jesus. We love you for it. We give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry. I fall and take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near, and the day is past and gone, at the river I'll stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, and take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand, for I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light, and take my hand, precious Lord. Lead me home.
Cesario Davila Hernandez. Cesario Davila Hernandez, 96, of Mineral Wells, passed away April 29th, 2019. At Holland Lake Nursing Center in Weatherford, Texas. Cesario was born February 25, 1923, in Matamoros, Coahuila, Mexico, to Cirilo Hernandez and Petra Davila. He married Socorro Villalba February 9, 1947, in Chihuahua, Chihuahua, Mexico. He was preceded in death by his wife of 71 years, a son Jesse, daughter Yolanda, and son Josue. He is survived by son Roy and Tracy Hernandez of Santo, daughter Maria and Rick Perry of Nolanville, son Arthur Hernandez of Mineral Wells, son Armando and Alma Hernandez of Waco, daughter Teresa and Mike Gerlach of Memphis, Tennessee. Daughter, Martha Morales of Weatherford. Son, David and Jody of Mineral Wells. Daughter, Rachel and Casey Daly of Weatherford. Son, Joel Hernandez of Weatherford. Son, Benjamin Hernandez of Mineral Wells. And 25 grandchildren, 30 great-grandchildren, and one great-great-grandchildren. The family would like to extend a special thanks to the following. Daddy's friends, of which he had many. Holland Lake Nursing Center, which did a magnificent job in the last year and few months that he's been there, taking care of him. Alpine Funeral Home, again, who did a wonderful job. If you saw my daddy there a while ago, he looked awesome. He looked wonderful. Praise the Lord. Truth Tabernacle Church family and the Waco Life Church family also. A very special thanks to Pastors Larry Lynch and Jeremy Lynch. And last but not least, my son-in-law Jonathan and Andrea Walker for their great work on the slideshow presentation. Also for the prayers and the beautiful plants and flowers that we have received. About a little over a year ago, we were at Harris Hospital in Fort Worth. It was, I believe, on a Wednesday night, and my wife and I were fixed. Well, we were still there for a while, but we left that night thinking that we would never see Daddy alive again. And I had gone out of the room, and when I came back, my wife shared something with me that was very, very special. She said that she noticed that Daddy was staring off into the distance there in the room, just looking, like focused, and that she asked him, father-in-law, which is actually suegro. It sounds better in Spanish than it does in English to me. She says, father-in-law, she said, what are you looking at? And that he evidently did not hear, or he was so focused that it didn't register. So she asked him again, and he never took his eyes off of what he was looking. He was just staring, like very focused, like he was looking at something. And she said, what are you looking at? And he said, I'm at the river. She sat there a while, and then she said, why don't you cross? And he said, it's not time yet. And so, again, that night didn't get any better as far as my dad was concerned, and it looked to me that he was going to die that night more than likely. So we left, went back to Waco, thinking that we wouldn't see him again alive. I went home, and I started working on a poem, and I couldn't put it together for nothing. I know why now. And so, now that he's gone, a year and a few months later, I was able to write a poem. And it came so easy, as did my mother's. And so now, if she's able to, my daughter's fixing to come up and read that poem. Thank you.
An enduring smile, written by my dad for his dad. A little over a year ago, tired, weak, and slow, he came to the river and watched its flow. And though we thought that he was going to cross the river that day, the Lord showed him that he must stay. And so he stayed, smiling most every day. He carried his cross with a smile on his face because of the crown of life at the end of the race. He ran the race with strength and grace. And in spite of the trials of his long, hard life, he always prayed throughout his strife. And though things were rough the last long mile, upon his face was that warm, enduring smile. His fight of faith is finished now. And how he lived for God deserves a bow. And so, as we let him go, this do I know, that some sweet day, if I live God's way, in just a little while, I shall see my dad and bask in his warm, enduring smile. Grandpa was always smiling. So thankful.
Again, I would just express a gratitude to everybody this year, all his friends, those that helped take care of him, family, of course. My daddy was an incredible husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and great-great-grandfather. He was a tremendous role model, an enduring example, and inspiration to me and many others. Daddy's childhood was very hard. He grew up, his mother died two or three years later after she had him, after she had a little girl, I believe. And his dad got married to a woman, naturally, that would become his stepmother, and she was very, according to Dad's story, was very cruel to him. I'm not going to dwell too much on that, but his life as a young child was very, very difficult. I'm going to jump over to his young married life. He was very committed to mother. 71 years together, 12 children. He was very committed to mother. I remember him telling me stories, and I remember vividly back where we were raised in Carlsbad, New Mexico, on a farm there. And Daddy would work 10, 12 hours a day out in the fields. This is when the family was still very young, and would come in from work, and Mother went for a period of time where she had a lot of problems, a lot of physical problems. And so it would wind up that Dad would be up most of the night tending to her, maybe the kids, because she was just so sick. And so he was a very committed man to her. And my mother is with him right now, literally. His walk with God impressed me tremendously. He was very dedicated to the Lord. He was very dedicated to the things of God. He had a passion for God's word. 2 Timothy 4:2 says, "Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine." And he did that, folks, every chance he got, whether it was family in Mexico, where we would go pretty regularly, he would preach the word to them. He would teach. He would exhort. He would encourage. And that's what we're supposed to do. If we're living for God and living for God, God's way, we should be committed and obligated to speak God's word, not to be ashamed of it. And so Daddy was very, very zealous about the things of God. He did it consistently. He did it with patience, as the scripture said. And I like what he did. He taught in parables, as Jesus did. He thought it was easier for people understanding, and it is. And so I just praise God for what he sowed already. The seed that he sowed all over wherever he was at, he sowed a seed. And someday, praise God, I believe that we're going to reap. I believe that with all my heart. He gave me several things, folks, many things, actually. In fact, he gave me this suit about 40 years ago, 35, 40 years ago, believe it or not. I don't think he ever wore this suit because he couldn't have got in it. You know, I think he probably got it at a garage sale and gave it to me, and that's okay. Mom would get things at the garage sales and give them to me that she thought I liked. And so at the moment I got a suit that Daddy gave me, I'm wearing a watch that Daddy gave me. It's an antique, I believe. That makes it more special. He gave me several things, folks, over the years. But the thing that he gave me that I find the most important thing that he gave me is the love for God's word. Yes. At the expense of sounding corny or whatever you may think, it's fine. I love the word of God because it's life. And it's life eternal if we follow the word. He not only gave me the love for God's word, the legacy of his faithfulness in his walk with God is something that I don't ever want to take for granted, and I don't want it to be in vain. Ecclesiastes 7:1 says, "A good name is better than precious ointment, and the day of death better than the day of birth. I wish I had time to elaborate on that scripture, but I'm not going to. I'm sure you understand pretty much what it says. In Ecclesiastes 7 and 8, it says this, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. And the patient in spirit is better than the proud in spirit. My dad fought a good fight. He finished his course, and he kept the faith. And without a shadow of a doubt in my mind, as the scripture says, there is laid up for him a crown of life that the Lord himself, the righteous judge, shall give him at that day. Thank you.
Thank you for that beautiful song. I want to read a couple of scriptures quickly today. I won't take very much time, but I want to read John 13 and 15. The Bible says in John 13 and 15, "For I have given you an example that you should do as I have done to you." And then 1 Timothy 4 and 12 says, "Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity." These scriptures both speak about being an example. Of course, in John, Jesus was the example. But when I think of Brother Hernandez, I think of someone who is a great example of what it is to be a Christian. Just like Jesus said in John that he had done some things as examples for us to follow in and to follow after. I believe that part of our calling as a Christian is, in fact, to be an example to somebody else. And nobody did that better than Brother Hernandez. And that's exactly what he was to me. He was a great example. As a young person who grew up in the same church as Brother Hernandez, I can truly say that he was a man who was a great example to the young people. He did not despise the young people in the church, but in fact, he was an example that we could look up to and we could say, you know what, I want to be like that someday. I want to be the kind of Christian that he is. He was an example in every way. He was an example in word, as the scripture said, and in his conversation, in his love, in his spirit, in faith, and in purity. In every way, I can't think of any way that Brother Hernandez was not a great example to me personally. And I know that from experience, he cared about me, even as a young person and even as an adult. It didn't matter to him. He didn't look at me any different in one time of my life or another. He always cared about me. He would take time out of his out of the service and always make sure to come and find me and give me a word of encouragement and to pray with me at the altar. I can't tell you how many times that Brother Hernandez would be there at the altar praying for me and praying with me. And when I was seeking for God's Spirit, he was always there encouraging me, praying with me. And that's the memories that I have of Brother Hernandez, is that example to me, that encouragement to me to live for God, amen, to keep pressing on even when I didn't feel like it. I can think of the many times that Dad would have him stand up and pray for the service or pray before he was about to preach. And, you know, I couldn't understand 99% of what he said, but that didn't matter because I could feel what he said. I could feel the Spirit, and I knew what kind of man he was. And when he would sing, we were talking about that with Andre before church, it didn't matter that you couldn't understand him if he was singing in Spanish, because you could feel the Spirit moving and you could see the love of God in him. And then, of course, there was all the times that he would simply encourage me, and not just me, but the whole church, to stay in the boat. Stay in the boat. Amen. I don't care what's going on outside of the boat. I don't care what's going on outside of the ship. I don't care how bad the storms may be. And we've had some storms around here the past few days. But in life, we're going to have a lot of stormy weeks like we've had this week. And it's going to get difficult. And when you're living for God, sometimes you feel a little uncomfortable when the boat begins to shake. And it begins to toss and turn in the ocean. But Brother Hernandez would always encourage us, stay in the boat. Amen. No matter what happens. And I thought of that song that says, "So let the storm clouds rage high, the dark clouds rise, they don't worry me. For I'm sheltered safe in the arms of God. He walks with me and none of earth can harm me. I'm sheltered safe within the arms of God." Amen. It doesn't matter what's going on outside. We've got to stay in the arms of Jesus Christ today. And we can be sheltered in his arms. He loved the church. He loved the people of God. Even the last time that he was here, amen, has already been said, and I don't want to spoil the slideshow, but you're going to get to see a little bit of that. The last time that he was here at his own wife's funeral, he couldn't help himself but to stand up here one more time and invite some people to church. Amen. He wanted to let everybody know, come to this church. We want a big church. Amen. And I love him so much for that, for being that kind of example, inviting people to church, amen, at his wife's funeral. He loved the church. He loved the people of God and the work of God. And I believe that all those words of encouragement over the years, all of those words that he would give to me are part of the reason why today that I'm here in this service today. Amen. He helped me to do just that, to stay in the boat. Amen. That's why I'm in the boat today. That's why I'm not perfect, and neither was Brother Hernandez. But we try. We try our best to live for God. Amen. It is men like Brother Hernandez that were faithful to church and in every other way. It is men like that, that's why I can be faithful to church today. Because I saw that example growing up, and it instilled in me something that I want to carry on. I want to pass that along to somebody else. Amen. I want to be an example to someone else to be faithful. Brother Hernandez was faithful to church. He was faithful to his family. Those are things that I looked at and I saw the kind of faithfulness that he had. His faithfulness in caring for Joey. Just a great example of a great father. When I see his faithfulness to church, when I've seen his faithfulness to his family, when I've seen his faithfulness in caring for Joey, that tells me all I need to know about the kind of man that Brother Hernandez was. So, yes, I am going to miss Brother Hernandez. Even though he had not been very well over the past few years and had not been able to be at church over the past few years, just the thought of knowing that his example won't be around anymore is kind of tough to take. That this time, this moment, in this hour, it is time for me. It is time for some of you to be that example. It is time for us to be that example to the youth and to encourage them and to strengthen them. And so today, if I'm sad, and I know many of you are, if we are sad in this service, if we shed a tear, it is not for Brother Hernandez, because we rejoice with him today. Because we know that he is in a much better place. Amen. And so if we are sad, we are sad for us today. Because we have lost a great example of faith and a fine Christian man. We have lost a great father. We have lost a great saint of God. Example for us. And so this earth, this place we call home, is not quite as good of a place as it was a few days ago, because we have lost such a fine example like Brother Hernandez. Amen. It's not as good of a place as it was a few days ago. We're going to miss him so much. And so I'm thankful today, and I rejoice with Brother Hernandez. Amen. That I rejoice that he is in that heavenly reward today, that he so much deserves today. Amen. He's with his wife today. And I thank God today that I got to be just a little part of his life. Amen. God bless you today.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain.
I was just sitting here thinking that I wished I had some more personal memories of Brother Hernandez, some more specific examples, maybe I should say. But really, it was the lifetime of memories that made the biggest impact on me, the lifetime of faithfulness. But I know there's some of you out there that maybe also have some memories that you want to share. Some family here today. And so what we want to do at this time is open this up. And I know many of you may be nervous to come up here. You're welcome to just stand in the front if you don't want to come up here, whatever you feel like doing. But if you're not a public speaker, sometimes it can be a little, make you a little nervous. But I want to encourage a few of you to come up here and just share something, if you would like to, about your dad or your grandpa. Amen. So we want to just open that up now. If you have a memory or if you just want to say whatever you feel on your heart, just come on up here and we'll let you say it. So who wants to be the one to be brave and jump out here first? All right. Y'all don't leave me hanging up here now.
This is from my Aunt Teresa. Daddy, he wore many hats throughout our lives. He was the best dad, a loving husband, a loyal friend, but most importantly, he was dedicated to the Lord and an amazing role model. He encompassed the qualities of an exceptional man. He was forgiving, honest, loyal, loving, generous. He was slow to anger, and I wanted to add, and quick to love. And he had a smile for everyone. We will miss him, but know he is having a wonderful reunion with Mom. From Teresa, I love you, Daddy. And this is from my Aunt Rachel. What an amazing role model my father was. To have the honor to have him as my father, and what a privilege it was to care for him. God knew what kind of father I needed, and I'm so blessed to have such an amazing role model. And I want to thank Aunt Rachel for taking care of my great-grandpa.
Thank you very much for that. Anybody else? Amen. Anything you say, I know will be wonderful.
this is, you know, my dad was like a comedian, you know, he was always joking and, you know, saying this and that and making us laugh and so forth. And about, I guess it was about a year and a half ago, maybe a little longer than that, I was visiting my parents. Sorry, Daddy. and Mom and I had cooked something and we were eating and we had given Mom her food and Daddy and I were talking at the table. And then he turned around and looks at me and he says, "You know what? You look 80. And I said, "Really, Daddy?" He said, "No," he said, "I'm sorry, I lied. He said, you look 90.
Yes. Amen. That's wonderful. Come on, Andrea. I see you coming.
I can't let a moment pass just to give honor to my grandfather, and I agree with Aunt Marie. He was so much fun. I have a lifetime of memories, like Jeremy said, of his faithfulness to church, and I'm so thankful that I got to share that with him. I will treasure that always, and I want to carry on that legacy that he started. He left a legacy, and I'm very thankful. Whenever I was talking to my cousin Mariah, we were talking about his nicknames for us. He had nicknames. And she said, "Did you have a nickname from Grandpa?" I said, "Yes, I was always Andrea La Vanessa." And I said, "What was yours?" She said, "I was always Mariah La Papaya." And Tina was Tina La Ballerina. I later named Tina Purina Puppy Chow. But we all had nicknames. You all probably had a nickname for Grandpa. I'm sorry that I don't know them all. He called Jeremy all, he always called him in Spanish, Jeremias. He always, and Jeremy knew that too, he was talking to, even if Jeremy didn't speak Spanish, that's, Grandpa always called him that. And I'm so thankful for Grandpa and his sense of humor. You know, he could always make a situation fun. You know, he could always kind of lighten the mood, I guess you could say. And I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for that example. And like I said, I want to carry on the legacy that he left for me and for all of us, and I pray that we all will do that together in his memory and his honor.
Thank you. Anybody else? We're not in a hurry today. We're here to honor a great man, so come on.
I just want to say a few words. I'm going to miss my mom and dad. God granted them a beautiful family. I got some pretty sisters, nice looking brothers, what can I say? And I'm going to miss them. I want to thank everybody that come out here this evening. Thank you.
Amen. God bless you.
Thank you guys for showing up to this. Beautiful, beautiful. I wanted to say, when Jeremy was growing up, he was probably about 7 years old. He says, "Grandpa," he said, "when you go to heaven, could I have your coin collection?"
Thank you for everybody coming out. It just, one day my wife and I, we went over to my parents' house. We were in the backyard helping Dad clean up the yard. And that's when they had a little Chihuahua dog. And Mother come out. She was griping at Dad about the dog being in the flower beds. Well, Dad, he waits till Mother goes back in. Then he tells me and my wife, Jody, "Don't worry. I think I can still take your mother." And that has been just, thank y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for coming out. One day I was over eating lunch with my dad, and my mom was tearing into him pretty good and about something he had done or something. He's just calm as could be, and I asked him about the time she's putting the plates down on the table, and I said, "Dad, why are you putting up with this? Why don't you say something to her?" He said, "Just eat your lunch, son." And I said, okay. So after I finished eating, I sat back and I said, God, this is the best food in the world. He goes, that's why.
This is wonderful. Thank you. These are the kind of things that we're going to love later, is these memories that we have.
For those of you that don't know who I am, I used to be married to their oldest son, and my name is Mary. And I'm sorry. I hope I can resist.
So my name's Courtney. Grandpa was my great-grandpa. I'm going to read this from my grandma. It's When Tomorrow Starts Without Me. When tomorrow starts without me, please try to understand that an angel came and called my name and took me by the hand. The angel said my place was ready in heaven far above and that I'd have to leave behind all those I dearly love. But when I walked through heaven's gates, I felt so much at home. For God looked down, smiled at me, and told me, welcome home. So when tomorrow starts without me, don't think we're far apart. For every time you think of me, I'm right there in your heart.
Thank you for that. This is one of my favorite parts of these services, is getting to hear these stories and memories and things that y'all share. So anybody else? Here in just a moment, we're going to start the slideshow that Jonathan and Andre have prepared, but if I'll give you one last opportunity here if anybody wants to come say something. All right.
I'm nervous, guys. I've always liked being the center of attention, but this just makes me nervous. I think my favorite memory was how brave he was. He taught me how to drive. You know, my dad was always busy, and my mom, she wasn't patient enough. But even though I was hitting curbs and driving him all around Mineral Wells with Ben and me and him, and he was just calm all the time. He never got mad. Uncle Ben would be like, Kelsey, you better not hit that curb. And I'd say, it's fine. It's fine. And Grandpa would go, Mija, you're good. And I'd be like, okay. I'm like, good. So now I know how to drive. And when I'm on the road, I'm like, why can't y'all drive? Just, but yeah.
Thank you. Apparently, we lost a good driving instructor, too. So maybe I could have had Ethan work with him. Anybody else? One more person. I'll give you another opportunity here. All right. If not, then we're going to start a slideshow at this time.
Go rest high, your everyone who come and the one who don't come. I appreciate all the people and all the children and all the service that we have here. Come to the service that we have here. And beautiful. You can see the glory of the Lord and the words of the Bible. Why don't you come and be with us? They have a big church like the Bible says. The ones that don't have the Word of God, they're going to live forever.
That's right.
We're going to live forever in the spirit, not in flesh. But I want you to understand that all those what I have before that I don't obey because I don't understand. When I understand that his ear wasn't true because the Lord showed me and his church it wasn't true. And I believe it with all my heart.
Yes.
Yes, I believe it with all my heart. God bless God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Mijo. Mijo. Whatever it is, say the word.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you and bless everyone that is here. All the people. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I think it'd be appropriate if we just lifted our hands and loved the Lord today. God, we love you and we thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Thank you for your presence. Ask you, Lord, to have your way, Lord. We give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wow. I said, wow. That seems to be the only word appropriate for today as I have sat back there and listened to everyone that's spoken, all the children. I've beheld this beautiful family and heard such kind words and words about Brother Hernandez, words like example, faithful, hardworking. Those are things that describe somebody that really is unique in our world today. And when we think about that, we just think, wow. Because it's going to be a wow situation when we get to heaven. In fact, the Lord orchestrated it in such a way that there will be 30 minutes of silence. Now, that's for Pentecostal people, that's going to be amazing, isn't it? 30 minutes of silence. Because you know what's going to happen? We're going to get there and we're going to look around. Wow. That's what I'm feeling today. I didn't have any of this written down, but that's what I'm feeling today. It's my honor to be able to speak just for a moment today, and I do greet each of you in the name of Jesus Christ. I've been asked to say just a few words concerning a man that lived his life for the Lord. I was honored to meet the elder brother Hernandez when he would visit the Waco Life Church a couple of times, and then, of course, at his wife's funeral, able to be there during that time also. And it was readily apparent that he had a deep relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. It's no secret that he had friendships with many people, but the most important relationship that anybody can have is that relationship with Jesus Christ. He loved to worship. He loved to talk about the goodness of God. Brother Hernandez, Armando Hernandez, and Sister Alma Hernandez, of course, attend the church that I pastor, and they've talked about him extensively to me. He was used of God extensively in Carlsbad, New Mexico, doing the work of the Lord there, preaching, teaching, testifying about salvation and the power of this great gospel. The power that the gospel has to save, to give you restraint, to give you control, and to give you a better life. And he was convinced of that. Today we're celebrating a life, and for us it may be that he's gone on, and what touching words we've heard today, beautiful poems. Death is never really easy for the family, but it's never the end. It's a new beginning. Death is not the master of the house. Death is only the porter at the lodge. And he's appointed to open the gates to the king's guest into the realm of eternal day. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Brother Hernandez has entered into those eternal realms of eternity. One long day with no night. Weeping, the psalmist said, may endure. He didn't say that it would, but he said that it may endure for a night. But joy comes in the morning. What kind of morning? It's a symbolic morning. It's a metaphoric morning. It's a spiritual morning, and Brother Hernandez is enjoying that morning. Hallelujah. Because he was baptized in Jesus' name. Because he lived a repentant lifestyle. And because he was filled with the Holy Ghost. He's enjoying a morning today like no other morning. I don't know about you, but I'm a morning person. Now, neither one of my kids are morning people, but I'm a morning person. I enjoy the mornings. But there will be a morning that I will enjoy much more than any other morning. Hallelujah. He's left his legacy to his children and to all of us who follow him. And, of course, his son, Armando, is one of the finest Christians I've ever known. But he didn't get there by himself. He had a father and a mother that gave him examples. A father is so important in the world, and no doubt he loved his children unconditionally, but he wanted them to follow the examples of the Lord Jesus Christ. My perspective today is from what I've seen with Brother Armando Hernandez and his family, and I've watched him even with his own grandchildren and the love that he shows them and how he desires for them to worship the Lord and to serve God. He didn't learn that on his own. He learned that from his father. I watched some grandchildren today that were moved by the Spirit of the Lord as they spoke or spoke for other people even, as they read poems and they felt the presence of God. They didn't learn that by themselves. It's passed down. It transcends through the generation. God calls families. He didn't just call one man. We heard, I thought, wow, when we heard about grandchildren and great-grandchildren. And quickly, I'm an English person, I'm not a mathematician, but I'm pretty good. And so quickly, I added up about 75 people. Just real quick, and there's probably more than that. From one man and one woman. And that spirit transcends down from them. And how you see the world is because of how he saw the world. I heard a story several years ago, and it was about a snowy day. And a man found himself in a place on that snowy day that he shouldn't be. It was an establishment that he shouldn't have visited. And then he looked up, and his little boy was there with him. And he said, son, what are you doing here? How did you even know how to get here? And the little boy replied, oh, it was easy, Dad. I just followed your tracks. I think Brother Hernandez left some tracks for us to follow. Yes. Tracks of loyalty. Tracks of faithfulness. Tracks of honesty, tracks of submission, tracks of inheritance, tracks of worship, tracks of hard working, tracks of consecration. Hey, let's follow those tracks today. Amen. I said, let's follow those tracks today. The boat that he referred to, that's talking about the church. Let's get in the church. We have a word picture of the boat in the Old Testament. We call it Noah's Ark. It was the only thing that made it, Brother Rayleigh, that boat. Let's get in the boat. Let's follow the Lord. Somebody said, well, there are some things in that church I don't like. It probably didn't smell too good on that boat sometimes. But it was better inside the boat than outside of the boat. Hey, let's do what he said. Let's get in the boat. Hallelujah. It's my privilege to be here today, and I've enjoyed every bit of this service, and to all the family. I've lost my father, and so I understand where you are today, and it's not a good place to be, but the Lord will help you. I promise you, the Lord will help you, and I love each one of you. May the Lord richly bless you.
Amazing grace,
saved a wretch like me.
Amazing grace. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The grace of the good Lord that made us what we are today. Without God, we would be nothing. But with Him, I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. I was talking to Jeremy, and we was talking, and he said, I'm not going to worry too much about what I say, because this will be the easiest time that I could ever talk. It'll all just come from memory. And I thought, yeah, I'm not going to worry too much. I'm not going to stress about Brother Hernandez's funeral, because I just know everything about him. But now, after hearing all of this, I wondered if I should have studied a little more. Mercy, the beautiful things that was said about Brother Hernandez. My, my, my. What a lovely man Cesario Hernandez was. Brother Jeremy was talking and he stole some of my thunder. I guess he was raised listening to me a little bit too much, whatever. But he was a faithful man. He was one of the best men that I have ever met. And really, after all that's been said, there's still a lot that could be said. Volumes would not hold what Brother Hernandez done in his life. In the book of Romans, chapter 4 and verse 20, he staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform. Brother Hernandez was a man that staggered not at what God spoke to him. He was a man that took God at his word. He was just that kind of a man. Amen. We have heard the perspective of Brother Hernandez from a son. We have seen the perspective of Brother Hernandez from his children. They all loved him. Grandchildren, great grandchildren. We have heard from a young man that sat in a church where Brother Hernandez influenced his life. And we are seeing you here today also that tells me that you loved this man. I want to talk today about this man from the perspective of his pastor. For 40 plus years, I have had the pleasure and the privilege of watching this man live for God. We heard Brother Hernandez, Armando Hernandez, say today that his dad had a rough childhood and that he was brought up in roughness, but he took that and did not take that as an advantage to do wrong. But instead, he took the things that were wrong and made them right. Yeah. Amen. He received the baptism of God's Spirit into his life. He was born again into the kingdom of God. Amen. He began to look at things different than what he used to. He grew in faith and knew that God would do what he said he would do. Amen. He knew that if he said it, he would fulfill those promises that he said that he would do. Amen. That was the kind of a man that C.D. Hernandez was. He was a man of faith, a man of great faith. He staggered not. Amen. He passed the test of his life at every corner, at every place. Brother Hernandez passed that test. He was faithful to God. He never left God. He may have felt like, as I have it many times, that I have failed God. But Brother Hernandez never one time turned his back on God and walked away. He was faithful to his family. He loved his family. I have never heard Brother Hernandez say to me personally one word, not one, against his family. He could say to you, as I have said many times, say what you want to about me, but just leave my family alone. And that's the way he felt today. Amen. He would take the heat, but leave his family alone. He loved them. Amen. His children. He had, did you say 12? 13? altogether involved in his life, and he loved every one of them. He tried his best to teach them the truth. I'm not telling you a fairy tale. I'm talking about a man that loved God. I'm talking about a man that worshiped God. I'm talking about a man that loved his children.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Even with the burdens that his children bore, and Jeremy mentioned so eloquently, brother, his little Joy. Amen. Joy is a precious child. Amen. He is. Sometimes we have angels unaware in our midst, and we don't understand altogether what it's about. But when Joey came into his life, he did not stagger at that. But he said, you know what? God gave him to me, and I'm going to do my best to raise him. He didn't say that verbally, possibly, but he said it through actions. And actions are always louder than words. Everybody say amen. He never wavered. He never one time. He was absolutely, amen, delighted that he had a family as he had. Amen. I look at you today. I see you. And I look at you, Roy and Arthur and Armando and David and Ben, and I'm missing one. Joey, these boys, you're going to miss your daddy. He's precious to you. He loved you when no one else would love you. He cared for you when no one else would care for you. He loved you beyond the natural love. He loved you to the point he wanted you to be born again like he was, so that you could enjoy the same power with God that he enjoyed. Martha, Maria, you're going to miss him. Amen. He is going to be a place in your life that you're going to reach for, and you're going to, you know, it's not there anymore. Rachel, one more girl. Teresa, never forget Teresa. Amen. They're going to miss their dad. There's so many of them, I have to thank them. And look what the marriage of two people started. Look at all this group around here. Could you imagine that? But it happened, and Brother Hernandez, I'm going to put it on his shoulders. He was responsible for that. Amen. He's the man. But through it all, he still loved you. Everybody say amen. And you know what? I consider it an absolute delight to have been his pastor. Amen. He supported me in every way. He never said anything to me that was negative. Amen. He never said anything derogatory at all. He apparently loved me when I would go to the nursing home. I would try to go there on a weekly basis. Sometimes I would miss it and have to wait till the next week. But he always, when he saw me coming, and he would reach his hand out. His hand got a little weak at the end. But he would... Sometimes it looked like he was reaching for the other hand to try to push that hand forward. And he would say, Brother Lynch, you know, and he was just a pleasure to be around. That was the kind of a man he really was. And he had that same kind of love for all of you. Amen. He never was a backbiter. He never told you what you were or what you were not. He just prayed for you. Everybody say pray. Amen. Prayer does more for us than anything else in the world. When we get serious with God and we become an intercessor, I'm here to tell you, things will happen in the Holy Ghost. Amen. God will move. Amen. He was there. Amen. He was right there until the very end, doing his best to love you with all of his heart. What a man. How many of y'all believe that? Why don't you lift your hand and thank God for Brother Hernandez? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. 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 He was a man who led. He was a man who staggered not. He took the promises of God and he used them in the right way. Everybody say amen. Romans 4:24 says, but for us also to whom it shall be imputed. Amen. If we believe on him that raised up Jesus our Lord from the dead. Yes. Yes. Amen. Everybody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who was delivered for our offenses. We all have sinned. We all have come short of the glory of the Lord. But Jesus died for us and was raised again for our justification. I'm telling you, Brother Hernandez has gone on. But he has left a legacy that will never die. Somebody said he's gone. No, he's not. His influence will always be here. His life will always be before us. We'll always think about him. For he was the man that cut a path in your lives that no one else will ever do for you. What a beautiful spirit he had. What a smile. Everybody say amen. 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 What a smile. You know, I know we're supposed to be weeping today. And I know that at the loss of a father or a wife or a husband or whatever, a child, it just breaks our heart. Amen. It just does something to us that we cannot locate, but yet through it all, I cannot help but to raise my hands and my voice and say, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Amen. I know that Brother Hernandez, and I'm not taking a cheap shot, but he is really and truly in the arms of a loving God. Amen. He is resting today. Amen. All pain is gone, and he is there with the Lord Jesus Christ. And I just want you to know that I have appreciated, been delighted to have been a part of his life during these years. He's encouraged me when no one else would be at church. And everybody else, you know how it is. We live in that day and age. When no one else, sometimes they'll find excuses here and there, and you know, little issues come up. And some of them are true. There's reasons for things. But, you know, he looked beyond all that, and he said, I'm going to be there. Right. And he would get up here, and he would sing, and you could just see the anointing of God. I've seen him get up here and preach, you know, he would just kind of jerk under the Holy Ghost. And I thought, my God, amen, that is the real, he wasn't putting on. Amen, he wasn't natured that way. He moved under the power of the Holy Ghost. And that is so beautiful. Everybody say hallelujah. Amen. At the end of this service, and we're about to conclude here, we would like for all the rest of you to please excuse yourself for a few moments and let the family enjoy themselves. After you have viewed, amen, Brother Hernandez, and have passed on by, if you would excuse them for a few moments and let them just be with him alone. Can everybody say amen to that? So let's pray. We're concluding this service, and I know that God is going to give you strength. Everybody say amen. God is going to give you power. God is going to give you the ability to rise up and say, all is well. I preached a lot of funerals in my time, but truly, never has one been any easier than C.D. Hernandez. Let's pray. Lord, I love you. I thank you, God, for your word, Lord, that is so rich in our lives. I thank you for the fact, God, that we have had Brother Hernandez in our lives, that has loved your word, God, that has taken it to heart, that staggered not at your promises. But Lord, he was a soldier of the cross. Through every hard spot and every anxiety and every frustration, he still held calm and peaceful and knew that you was the answer to all things. I know that if we could cry until this time next year, that it would not wash away the hurt or the pain in the hearts of these loved ones, and even us, for we loved him also. But we want you to strengthen them, Lord, and touch them now. And we'll thank you for it. And everybody say, in Jesus' name. God bless you. We turn this service to our funeral directors.
There's a blessed time that's coming.